All right, we're here with take two of episode 41, the Midway region. Lost the stream earlier because the SimCity had crashed on me. So, anyway, we're here with another try. So we've got a lot to do in this city yet, including naming it. But we'll get there. First thing, we need to put in some power, or some, excuse me, some sewage and some water in this section over here. Anyway, give it another try. So we've got a lot to do in this city yet, including naming it. But, we'll get there. With the water being over here, I'll put the sewage on this side so it'll help fill this area out. Let's do it this side. That way, too, the water can be farther away from the recycling plant. I don't remember, I don't believe it causes pollution, but it might have a little bit. Oops. Multiplopper will let you put down one too many if you want, and maybe a couple too many, but. Small flaw that I hope they fix with it soon. And then we'll put the water. Let's see. We might need another sewage, depending on how many people are in the city. It's the only thing I've run into once in a great while, is you'll need another sewage. And I'm trying to decide if I want to place it now or not. We can turn these off as well. Oops. Hey, Play. There's a small echo, or is it just my microphone? Because I don't see any echo coming through. Oh. Sorry, it's, the screen I'm using to monitor had the volume on. There you go. That should be fixed now. Sorry about that, and thank you, Play. Luckily, it was turned down all the way, and usually I have it muted, so it doesn't matter, but I forgot. A little bit of volume there. Let's leave room for another sewage, but we won't. I mean, I guess I'll place it, but I won't turn it on. Yeah, I know, Mr. Play. I should get a headset. I need a decent mic, too. Should start a fund. We'll put this out, and then we'll just turn the whole thing off. And then the water can go right over here. Something like that. Let's see, do I want to start it over here? Decisions. We'll do it over. There. Oh, I forget I gotta turn some of these off. Because I don't want to be taking up a bunch of money right away. Alright. So now that we have that in, this is good because there's actually enough room here for, like, the police station probably would be good there. Yeah, that's actually perfect. And I don't think I'm going to do drones in this city. I don't know. Could. But I don't think I want to. In. And then we'll basically turn everything off, pretty much. Oh, hello, GTA. Good to see you. And then really, these guys should have access to the whole neighborhood really easily. Then, where do I want to put the fire station? I guess I should look at health, too. So I could put the hospital or something over here. Because I have these big spaces that are unused. But the hospital actually fits in here. The way that I built it, anyway. Could do something like that. We could also put it out here, but this is a long way out. So many tough decisions. Alright, we're gonna put it right here, actually. Then we'll do this and this and this and all these things. And then these can go around the back. There, and that actually works out perfectly. And then, for some reason, this stupid thing's not approved right away. Alright, it's not approved yet in there either. We will turn, again, most of this off. Like usual. This should be a theme now. I like to place things and then turn it off. I find it's... Especially if I have the money for it, you know, it makes things a little bit easier later on. It's already built, don't have to worry about it, just have to turn it on. And hopefully, I'm letting this run for just a minute here, because hopefully this thing will approve. At some point. Well, alright, it'll approve sometime. We also, like this suggests, need to put in our city hall, which I think is actually a better use of, say, this space. Yeah, see, that would actually work out pretty well. It's kind of sunk in there, too, which is interesting, but I don't know if I like it. And we could put... Oh, it won't fit. I was going to say, we could put city hall over there, but... Well... Excuse me. Yeah, let's put it down here. And that'll look pretty good as we. Yes, yes, yes. Speaking of, anybody have a name? Come on. There's a couple people in the chat room. Somebody help me with a name. It's basically a residential city, so. Now we need to do fire, too. Let's see here. Now, actually, fire could work from over here because I'm going to use helicopters. Whoops. The only thing I'm worried about is any hazmat because I'll have a little bit of industrial. What new town? Put two of these on just to help keep fires down. One of those, and then two of these. And of course, we gotta place this stuff. We'll leave one fire marshal and one helipad open. Res 10. Come on. Something original. It's a really cool plot. Like, it's got this really neat view off this way of this bridge and stuff. And then if you look over this way, you see the rest of the region that I've built so far. Like, it's a cool area. So now we need schooling. And this is the one that I've been going back and forth on. Hewitt? What is it? I like it. We'll use it. But what is it? Do I go university and probably take part of one of these out, which is most likely. Yeah, I think that's what we're going to do, actually. The tin plant way, build lots of stuff and turn it off. Yep. Well, you know what I mean, though? Like, if you have the money from other parts of the region, build it now. So that way I can, and half the reason I do that, too, is so I know how big a building is. So I know what I have to work with. And then later when when you need a building turned on, you don't have to spend any money. You just flip it on. Oh, cool, Mr. Play. Or Play, sorry. Chase, whatever. All right. We're going to take this out. Ooh, or even better. Yeah, let's take it out, but let's make it a tunnel. So I can still have the connection. Yeah, see? And then I'll work, you know, the buildings of the university into there. I like that. I just wish it was giving me a center point. This is pretty close though. Yeah? A little off. Actually, I bet I know what I can do to help that. There we go. Let's try that. Oh, of course, it gives me no spots. See if I can get this to bulldoze down to where I want it to. Ooh, I think that might be right. Alright. You know what? That, I think, might be short enough. Ah, still no? Alright, fine. We'll have to deal with it being off-center just a little bit. I'm trying to figure out which side is closer, but I think they're both equally bad. Yeah, essentially. This side is slightly better. But even still, it doesn't look that great. So, alright. Not a lot I can do, I guess. It's not letting me get it right down to where I want it to, but that's okay. Now, I know I'm going to be able to fit, yeah, building here and here. But what do I want to do back here? If I can, yeah, I'll just draw one that way. And that way. And then that gives me another row, and I almost have another row back here. Damn, that's really, that's a little too far. But that should get me most everything should fit in there. And I guess we'll have some medium-density buildings or something in there. Maybe some low-density buildings back here. Maybe we'll get some high-wealth low-density, so it'll be, what are they called? Frat houses. So, alright, cool. We have that in. Now let's think transit. We're going to have all kinds of wealth in this city. So let's just put bus transit everywhere. And let's do bus transit. Okay, let's do the hot spots. Get some buses to go out here. Fire station, why not? Police station, of course. There. 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 And we'll put some of these in. In here. We're also going to need, man. Maybe we'll make this front section high wealth. I'm trying to think of where to put the airships, because I'm going to need to put those in as well to help get residential commuters in and out. You know what? Maybe we'll just take one of these squares down here and do it. Fits much better up here. It's too bad it doesn't fit in that little square. That would be perfect. Fits in pretty good down here too, actually. And that might work better. Oh, this is where the tourists come in, though. Shit, that's right. Alright. We'll put this one here. No. We'll still keep it where I was going to put it. But then we can put the add-on basically anywhere in the city, which is where the actual, where the tourists actually come in, or where the, excuse me, the residents actually come in. And that, where do I want to put that? So I could do it in here. That'll fit in here. That's actually a perfect spot for it. I didn't even know it was going to fit there. I like it. Because then they're on this highway and they can get into the city. All right. No boats, because we don't have any boats, but we do have trains. Streetcars. I could do streetcars, but I don't know that I really need to. We don't really need this little tail here either. Anything else that we're missing right off the bat? We could put our own buses in, because we do need to put our bus stops, but we could put our own actual bus terminal in. Do I want to do that? There's no really good for it. We'll wait. We'll see if we actually need it. If we get a lot of bus wait times, then yeah. But for now, no. We will, however, fill in some of these areas. Let's see. I suppose we can have a stop on the back side of each of these and even on the corner. There we go. Bus stops. Stopping the bus. This side here, we'll get the middle here. Bus stops are kind of annoying because you kind of need to place them everywhere, but then they're always in the way because they count as a place building when you're trying to, you know, draw roads and stuff. So you always end up cannot draw through place building. You're like, I swear to God, there's no place building there, but there is because it's a bus stop. I don't know that it matters. I like to alternate sides of the road. I'm pretty sure it probably doesn't matter, but whatever. I think it's fun. And why not? Alright. Now that we have that area appropriately covered. Yeah. I'm not going to wealth yet. We'll get the people in and see what we need. See what the region needs. All that good stuff. So let's just start zoning here. And if I remember correctly, the wind blows towards the back, yeah. From the way I'm facing. So then, so the car. across there, and that side. This is gonna be a lot of zoning for a minute. I hope you guys enjoy zoning. Woo, zoning! Yeah! You know, GTA, I feel that way sometimes, but then other times I feel like that is just so tedious. You know, to have to lay bus routes, so either way, I can figure it out. I figure it would. I could go either way on it, you know. Because I've played Cities in Motion, and it's a fun game, but you don't have to build the city while you're trying to lay out these routes. So that, I mean, it's, yeah. It would add a whole different element to the game. Now, I don't know if you've heard my idea yet, GTA, but this is my million-dollar idea that Max just needs to jump on and start paying me for. But my idea is this, and that's to take all the sim games and have them interact with each other. So you would, you know, us building SimCity would be building the towers that people would play, that play Sim Tower would manage. And those, and the people that would play The Sims would live in the houses and the towers in the city. So it, the whole thing rolls together. And so you could also then take a Cities in Motion thing into it and say, and roll that in to have somebody come in and plan all the routes for all the mass transit and stuff like that. So it, like, it would be a really cool, massively multiplayer city simulation. Like, that's, it's really what it would be, I guess. Oh, and I'm talking and forgetting to zone commercial. So, let's see here. We have, see you later, Tommy. 1, 2, 3, commercial. And then we'll do commercial on this side. And commercial on this side. Go. And then we'll do commercial on this side. And this will just get us approximately close. It's the 3-1-1 rule. Three residential. It's a percentage kind of thing, or ratio thing, you know. So for every little thing of residential you put down, you should have, or for every three residentials, you should have one industrial and one commercial. It's not perfect because the game, I mean, you know, you can't, it's hard to lay down the exact numbers of the same, of the, you know, the different things, but it does help you get close. Oh, that's true, GTA. I mean, it would definitely, yeah, you would be demolishing other people's work sometimes, but I think that if they worked it out, I mean, obviously it would take a lot of planning to get this thing working, but if they worked it out correctly, I think it could be super fun. Yeah, and a lot of programming. Let's see. Since I still want to focus so much on residential in this city, I think I'm actually just going to take this one to make it commercial. And this one. Let's do 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 3, 1. So yeah, we're still pretty close on that. It's just distributed out again, a little bit different, I guess. You know, though, GTA, that's the kind of programming that I really find fun, though. The simulation stuff, trying to understand how things interact with each other. I just find that really fascinating work to do. That perfect, man. I drew these out pretty good without realizing it. Now these are going to be small, but there's not a lot I can truly do about that because I have to fudge the straightness of the road there. No, I say that's the type of programming I would like to do. That is not the programming I do on a daily basis. I am a web developer. And in my current job, since I don't have a lot of actual experience in web development, even though I've been programming for 18 years, I've never really had a job doing it until I finally got a degree. But my current job, I basically just write email. You know, HTML emails. It's pretty boring. But I do get to do some fun work for the website that we have. You know, get to do some JavaScript stuff and some other fun stuff. But when I program my own stuff, I do it in Ruby on Rails. And, yeah. Oh, hello, Mentos and DavDav909. Good to see you folks. I guess we won't have to zone that, but fine. And perfect, we did leave ourselves enough room, so. Oh, and I forgot, I need to zone industrial too. Alright, and I guess if we're going to have industrial, it's going to be along this back row. I can't believe I totally forgot about that. You work as an engineer at Rolls-Royce. That's pretty cool. I want to be the guy that test drives the new cars at Rolls-Royce. Or better yet, the guy that test drives the new cars at Lamborghini. God, can you imagine having that job? Yeah, you got to make sure this thing can actually hit 200 miles an hour, so have fun. Alright, I'm pretty sure my balance is off because I wasn't really paying so much attention, but let's fire this thing up. I'm sick of zoning. Here, we'll put some residential right over here. And then we'll slowly but surely get people. Now it seems like my traffic system is working. We'll see how it goes, though. And of course, everything's yelling because they don't have pop, you know, they can't open yet. Rid of all the blinkies. There we go. Hey, Toady Wolf, thanks. We're just starting to grow it. I'm glad you like it so far. Oh, you do the jet engine stuff, GTA. That's even cooler. That's closer to the line of work that, like, you know, my dad did. He was a thermal physicist at Ball Aerospace. If you're familiar with the Kepler telescope that's up there looking for other planets, you know, Earth-like planets around other stars, that was one of the last projects my dad did before he decided to retire and go sailing for till he feels like he's done. That's cool. Oh, yeah, Chody Wolf, I just turned it on, so the hourly rate is pretty rough. So we're waiting for everybody to move in. No, Mentos, I haven't seen it, but I have noticed that it doesn't always happen. That six residents in the mega tower bug, where if you have a population, if you have an apartment level and they get down to six residents, that they don't always recover. I do notice that it's not all the time. It's about 25% of the time that it gets down to those six residents that it just won't come back. But much of the rest of the time, if you improve whatever the problem was, they'll come back. Oh, did we adjust our taxes? We didn't adjust our taxes. Embezzlement. Somebody stole friggin' $3,800 from me last month. There we go. With people starting to move in, a little bit of tax adjustment, we're about a third of the way there to making money. See, what I've tried to do with traffic in this city is give people direct routes, like a couple direct routes to their place, but the direct routes go very different ways. Oh, yeah, that's the first time you've had them come back? Yeah. Sometimes I'm impatient and I just bulldoze them anyway and rebuild, but they will come back a lot of the time. So far, so good on the traffic system. If you weren't here for the building of this is a triple-decker road. We've got a tunnel that goes all the way underneath. We've got a bridge that goes on top, and then we've got a surface-level road that's actually sunken in just a little bit. Here we can zoom in. There you go. So have some areas to move in. But time to upgrade City Hall. Which again, everything is taken care of, so we can just start, you know, putting on whatever we feel like. City burning. Alright. Let's just Let's just let the fire station be on. Because it is kind of far away. What's this yelling about? Trains. Oh, yeah, I gotta turn these trains on. Forgot about that. How about you? Crime has the upper hand. Okay. Let's let you have your police helipad, and then let's turn on a couple of these. And one of these. There we go. Do we have this stuff set to export? Yes. So now it's just a matter of watching and keeping up with turning things on as we need them. You'll notice we only have one power thing on. Okay, so we're not treating our injured. We need to turn some of these on. I know this is kind of far back in the corner, but it was a good spot for it. And this should be slowly but surely getting fixed. How's education doing? Treating most everybody. Treating. Teaching. We have a fairly strong pink tech line, too. It's good. Nobody's riding the plane. In fact, we can turn that off to save some money for now. Because we won't have anybody riding it until I get some high wealth. City burning. Well, they'll teach themselves not to light themselves on fire soon. Where do we want to put the mayor's house? The mayor can live right back here. This might not be a good place for this fire station. I was hoping that I could reach everything okay with, you know, helicopters, but maybe I can. I really thought I could, though. See, like, yeah, why aren't there any helicopters? Oh, because there's stuff burning down over here. Well, where's the helicopters over here? Like, there's no police vehicles responding at all. You say you're ready to respond to fires, but I don't see you responding to fires. Oh, no, it says ready to respond to fires. I don't know. I'm just going to move it. I was hoping that I could get away with it being over there, but apparently I can't, so. I am actually just going to put it in right here. Problem solved. And then we don't even need to bother with the fire marshals. Things will settle down in a second when people start getting educated. Oh, we can put SimCopter 1 down. Why not? Let's do it on this side, though. We can put in the mayor's mansion, which I'm thinking I might do right up here, because this is, you know, this curve kind of messes with some buildings. Then we'll be able to fly the helicopter to work. Looks like we're doing pretty good, though. Everyone's taking the bus and walking so far. I mean, obviously, we still have all low wealth, but that's pretty good. City burning. Why is my police station and helicopters not taking care of that? There they go. Take your time. No, Myron. You Sims in SimCity don't have a level of. They don't have an age as far as education matters. Everybody just goes to the university. Or to the elementary school, if that's all you have. I think we have everything researched, too. Everything that we really care about. Yeah, most everything research just completed. So, let's do these ones. This one will... lowers rehabilitation time. What's it? Does this fit up here? Ooh, this will fit up here too, though. I'll have to remember that, because that's a longer one. The School of Law is larger than the rest of the buildings. You can see they're all a little bit smaller. Let's do the School of Medicine first, because that people will be less sick then. And let's actually do it back here. So, am I going to raise land value? Yes, I'm going to get people to move into the city first, though. The cake led eight. Oh yeah, Myron. Now the reason to have more than one type of education is because it will raise your hat level, your education level faster. You'll get more hats more quickly. But I find a really good combination for that is to have your university or your community college or if you're going for low tech, you know, your high school, and then add a public library, and that'll help raise your education a little bit faster. Yes, exactly, Hector. The reason you might go for, say, a high school over a community college or a university is to keep your tech level low. And in either case, whatever your primary education building is, I always like to add a public library because it's, you know, education. And it's also medium wealth, it's like a medium wealth park. So it gives them happiness too and stuff, so. Here, in fact, we'll get rid of this little bit of zoning over here, and that's where we'll put it. How are we doing on this other stuff? Wow, still doing surprisingly well on power. I would have thought we'd have started using up our power by now. Same with water. Doing great on water. Everything's going good. Not collecting all of our garbage, though. So maybe need to turn on another garbage truck? That's weird, though, to not collect our garbage in that amount of time. I guess just because there's so many little houses along the way right now. It takes them forever to move along to each little building. And... What do I have for industry? Says Dr. Brony Gamer. just some industry back here. I'm trying not to focus on industry in this city at all. Like, I just have enough to kind of satisfy some demand. But this is basically a residential city. And I'm hoping that these will go to high tech. It takes time. But because, you know, like I said, they pollute less and it'll be nicer that way. Die Hard Salon. Well, and since we have so much money in the bank, let's lower our taxes quite a bit here. Oh, yeah, there's probably some stuff in here, but this is just a tax city. See, there's some little bit of coal there. There's some ore. No oil. A little bit of resources. I'm not sure, Hector. I think I will put maglevs in this city, mostly because it's so low to the ground. I think that they might actually look pretty good in the city. But I still haven't decided. I think I will. I don't have anything else using control net, so it would be really easy just throw in like one control net facility to cover all the maglev. And really, right now, everybody's walking. I mean, like, look at all these Sims walking around. That's excellent. This guy's trying to set his place on fire. Oh, yeah, no problem, Dr. Brony. How is our happiness and growth going? It's coming along. It's funny, you can actually watch this stuff grow sometimes. In fact, why don't we just lower our taxes all the way and just bleed money for a little while? Get everybody super happy. Move in real fast. Yeah, Hector, while walking is a super low pollution. It's the greenest of the green. I want all these greens to pop up. They say they're ready to go. And it looks like most of those are actually commercial. Yeah, see, the residents still need to happify. Oh, speaking of, let's do one of these two to make them happier. Oh, not that. We need one of these. House of Worship. Let's put in a temple. No, they have to actually visit it for them to get happy from it. So, where do I want to put it then? I don't want to block off all this zoning I did. I can do this. It can go down here at the corner. And that should make people happy too. Not that they're not. Everybody's pretty happy. But hey, construction underway for apartment buildings. Where are you? All right, got some over here. That's what we're looking for. And like I said, we're just going to bleed money for a while we get these Sims to move in. We got one rubble. Somebody else burned down. Yeah, what'd you do? Building fire? Yeah. They need to edumacate themselves. Still keeping up really well on education. I think we're going to flip on like two power things because this bump to medium is going to be big. Not like huge, but you know, bigger than one power can handle. The first one's free. The first what is free? Oh, zoom in a little? Yeah, I mean, there's not a lot to see yet, really. I'm kind of waiting on stuff to grow before I zoom in and start doing a lot of work. How much are we consuming right now? Oh yeah, we should be okay. And this one, let's turn on one of these. Oh, exactly. Zero taxes till they move in, and then bam! 12%! yeah, that's looking good. How's this doing now? Collecting everything great. All of them, none burned down, much less fires per day total. Deaths per day, doing good. We should actually just kick on these other couple of ambulance bays while the Sims are still stupid. Keep them pretty happy on that. Oh, and this finally approved. Oh, turn it off though. How's this going? Still pretty good. Do we actually have a lot of prisoners? Yes. So we need to turn these on. How's this looking? Pretty good so far. Mentos, yeah, that's... You know, honestly, I've seen that actually happen, where the only people worried about crime in the city were the ones right across the street from your police station, because your police level was at one where low-wealth people are just perfectly fine with it, but medium-wealth will just start to complain, and the police station was just enough wealth level to wealth up the people right next to it. So they're the ones that complain, so... Oh, yes, Sleepy, this is a solo region, so, these are all my cities that I've built next to them. And good to see you. But you came right at the end of the stream here, so I'm going to be ending the stream. I hope you guys have enjoyed. The next stream, we're going to really grow this place up and start hopefully bringing in some different wealth levels once we figure out exactly what the region needs a little bit better. So if you like watching what I do live, you can follow me on Twitch. You'll be notified when I go live there. And if you like watching what I do after the fact, just subscribe to my YouTube channel and you'll be notified when I post stuff up there. I hope you guys have enjoyed, and I hope to see you again soon.